Welcome everybody to your hot 60. If you're not in your child's pose already, let's turn over onto our belly side. Just kind of settle into the body here, letting those knees find the edges of the mat. Bringing your hips back to meet your heels. Just stretching those arms out in front of you. Allowing the belly to rest in between the thighs. Forehead might find the floor. Just taking a moment here, working on bringing that awareness into this room. Trying to leave everything else on the outside of that door. Maybe focusing on your breath. Taking some nice deep inhales through the nose. And just exhaling the air out. Nice even breath. We've got the next 60 minutes. Using this time however you'd like to today. Just remembering it's your time. Checking in with the body. Maybe using this time for more of a restorative practice. Letting the body just rest. Maybe challenging those postures that you've been missing. Going a little bit deeper. We're going to start class off with our collective breathing exercise. We inhale for the count of three. Holding it at the top of the lungs. And then opening the mouth, creating that audible H-A ha sound. Just imagining that you're fogging up a mirror in front of you. It will help you cleanse the breath from the body. We'll just do a few of these together, keeping in mind that it is a breathing exercise. You do have to put a little bit of effort into it. Let's just start by emptying out the lungs to prepare. And then taking a nice deep inhale for one, two, three, holding it right here at the top. Opening the mouth and exhaling all of that air out. Letting it all go. Let's do another inhale for one. Expand the ribcage for two. Really try to fill up the lungs for three. Hold it here. And exhale. Letting those hips sink a little bit closer towards the heels. Last one. Inhale for one, two, three. Maybe taking one more sip and letting it all go. Letting that last little bit of tension just roll off the shoulders. Just bringing those lips back together, resuming normal breath for the remainder of our practice. Maybe setting an intention for your class today. Using that intention throughout class to bring that awareness back into this room if it ever starts to wander. On the next inhale, let's rise up tabletop position. Stacking those knees right underneath the hips, hip width apart. Your wrists, elbows, shoulders all in one line. Keeping that core in nice and tight. Gaze stays down right between your hands. Take a nice big inhale. Let's lengthen the right leg back to the back wall. Pointing the toe, reaching that leg back. Now flex the foot, circle it around. Couple times to the right, to the left. Repointing the toe, let's bring the left arm up. Bicep by the ear, spread those fingers wide. Slide the left hand to the left side of the room, bending the back knee, reaching back, grabbing onto that foot, and if you've got it, let's kick into that hand. Creating that teardrop from the side, maybe looking up, just challenging your balance a little, and release it down. Let's do the other side. Inhale the left leg back, point the toe, really lengthen that leg nice and long. Flex the foot, let's circle it around. We're just loosening up at the ankle joint. Repointing the toe, bring the right arm up, bicep by the ear, spread those fingers. Glide the right hand to the right side, bending the back knee, reaching back, grabbing onto that foot and kicking into that hand. Nice and gently here, creating that nice teardrop from the side, maybe looking up, challenging your balance, and release it down. Curling your toes under, shooting those hips up nice and high, pressing back into that first downward facing dog. Just taking a moment here in down dog to start pedaling those legs out, shifting the weight from the right foot to the left foot. Making sure those fingers are still spread wide, those hands, they're about shoulder width apart. Pressing into the mat through the palms, lifting the hips up, getting the wrist crease out of the wrist, but maintaining a nice neutral spine. Your feet are about hip width apart with each pedal. I want you to try to bring those heels just a little bit closer to the mat. Now find a breath, take an inhale, come up high on the toes, bend the knees, let the belly find the thighs, keeping the tailbone up, getting a little bit deeper of a stretch throughout the shoulders. Tailbone reaches back up, lowering those heels down, maybe letting them come just a little bit closer to the mat. Now taking a peek at the top of your mat, take a big step all the way up towards those hands, staying hinged over, separating your feet hip width apart. Maybe using those fists for measurement, letting the belly just rest on the sides, grabbing onto opposite elbows, is ragdoll. If you want to find a little bit of movement in ragdoll, you can sway from side to side, feeling that nice stretch down the back of the legs. And now let's pause in the center, lowering those hands down in front of the feet, taking it into our spine twist. Take a deep bend in the left knee, straightening the right leg. Right arm's going to reach up nice and high. Gaze goes up, trying to get that chin in line with the shoulder. Now take it for a half wrap. Reach that right hand across that lower back. And release, float it down. Let's take the other side. Deepen in the right knee, straightening the left. Left hand reaches up, gaze goes up. Try to get the chin in line with the shoulder. Taking it for a half wrap. Reaching for that opposite side, maybe rolling that left shoulder open just a little bit deeper. And release, float it down. Heel-toeing your feet together. Taking it into our three little sun salutations. Really starting to link the breath to the movement. Inhale, lengthen. Come to a half lift. Let those hands just slide up the shins. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, let's rise all the way up to standing. Hands reach up overhead. Take a nice big stretch. When you're ready, on your exhale, gently forward fold right back down to the mat. Keep those knees nice and soft. Inhale, lengthen, half lift, lengthening the spine, lengthening through the crown of the head. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, let's rise all the way up. If you want to find a little bit of movement here, that's okay. Maybe a little bit of a back bend, whatever feels good for you. And then when you're ready, on your exhale, forward fold, right back down. Let's do one more. Inhale, lengthen, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. Trying to bring that forehead all the way down to the shins. Inhale, let's rise. Stretching it out. We're saluting our sun here. When you're ready, on your exhale, making your way right back down to the mat. Again, keeping those knees nice and soft. Inhale, let's lengthen, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. Hands are going to find the top of the mat. I want you to step those feet back. High push-up, plank position. Holding it right here for about 3 breaths. Nice, strong plank. To modify, feel free to drop those knees down to the mat. Keep the hips, shoulders, head all in one line. Now inhale, press away from the floor. Shifting forward slightly, let's slowly lower all the way down to the mat. Keep those elbows in tight to the body. Keep those hips up in line with the shoulders, letting the belly just find the floor. Flip the toes over, press up, baby cobra. Good. On the exhale, making your way back downward facing dog. This is our flow. We're going to do this often throughout this practice. It's going to help us transition between each posture. Just know that it is optional. Let's do it again. Coming back into that high plank. Maybe finding your up dog this time. Inhale, press away. Exhale, slowly lower. Maybe finding that hover. Flipping those toes over, pressing up. Upward facing dog. Again, maybe that baby cobra. And then on your way back. Exhale, back into downward facing dog. Let's do it one more time, maybe finding your own flow here, taking it through at your own pace. Just remember, you can drop those knees down to the mat to modify. You can skip this flow whenever you'd like. It's a great way to check back in with the body, check back in with your breath. Meeting back in downward facing dog, we're going to warm up our legs. Inhale that right leg high, point the toe. Now bend the knees, stack the hips. Take a breath here, keep those shoulders square to the mat. Right foot reaches back. Up nice and high, let's step it all the way into that right thumb. Chest comes up off the side just a few inches. Now reach those arms back towards the back wall. Really squeeze those shoulder blades together. Gaze stays down in front of that right foot. Inhale, let's rise. Press and lunge. Shoulders come above the hips. Exhale, option here to open up those arms into cactus. Opening up the heart. Hands reach back up. Press and lunge. Hands now find the heart. Take an inhale. On the exhale, twist towards the right side of the room. Right arm reaches back towards the back wall. Left arm's going to reach forward. Good. Come back to the center. Drop the hands down to the mat. Let's step that right foot back. Let's take it through a flow. Breathing back down. Dog. Left leg reaches high. Point the toe. Bend the knees. Stack the hips. Take that breath here. Left foot reaches back up. Let's step it all the way into that left thumb. Chest comes up, arms reach back. Nice power lunge option. You can always drop the back knee down to the mat. Inhale, let's rise, crescent lunge. Exhale, open up, cactus. Feeling that stretch across the chest. Arms reach back up. Hands come now to heart center, taking that inhale. On the exhale, twist towards the left. Left arm reaches back. Right arm's going to reach forward. Good. Back to the center. Drop the hands down to the top of the mat. Let's step that left foot back. Let's bow. Meeting back down, we're facing dog, adding on, moving on to our warriors. Right leg reaches high. We'll take about 3 breaths here, making some small adjustments if you need to. Trying to square those hips up towards the front here. Bringing that right thigh parallel to the floor, keeping that knee right above the ankle, and maybe pressing that knee up towards that pinky toe. Now just tuck the tailbone, let's open up warrior 2. Arms drop down parallel to the floor. Gazes out that right middle finger, keeping the shoulders above the hips. Flip the front palm up, let's reach past those toes and reverse our warrior. Left hand can slide down that back leg, feeling that nice stretch down the right side body. Good, back to warrior 2. Circle those arms around, let's step it back, let's take it through a flow. Meeting back, downward facing dog, left leg reaches high, flex the foot, bend the knees, stack the hips. Left foot reaches high, step it all the way into that left thumb. Back foot pivots down 45 degrees, rise up, warrior 1. Take those breaths here, making those adjustments, trying to square those hips up, bringing the left thigh parallel to the floor. Tuck the tailbone, open up, warrior 2. Sinking down, maybe just a little bit deeper, pressing that knee out towards that pinky toe. Let's flip the front palm up, reach past the toes, and reverse. Right hand can slide. Always an option here, you can take it for that half wrap. Come back, warrior 2. Circle the arms around, let's step it back, let's take it through a flow. Getting that body all warmed up for our standing series. Meeting back, down dog, maybe taking a couple more pedals here, shifting that weight around. When you're ready, coming up high on the toes, bend the knees, let's take a step or hop all the way up to the top of the mat, and slowly, one vertebrae at a time, we're going to round up to our standing position. Taking your time here. We're going to meet in the center part of our mat, heel-toeing those feet together. Taking a breath here in mountain pose, rounding those shoulders down and back away from the ears, palms facing forward, chin is lifted, standing up tall. Nice big inhale through the nose. And just exhale that air out. Crescent half moon is first, keeping the weight of your heels. Inhale those arms up, palms touch. Interlace the fingers, release the index. Cross the thumbs, glue the palms together all the way down to that wrist crease and keep the biceps right there by the sides of your head. Now finding a breath, take an inhale, lengthen up out of the way. On the exhale, begin reaching over for the right side of the room. Taking your time, this is a 60-second posture. Stay focused on one point in the front mirror. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, reach over a little bit further towards the right. Begin pushing those hips towards the left. You're working on creating that crescent half moon shape down the body. Really lengthening through the right side ribcage. Maybe imagining there's a big beach ball sitting right there on that right hip as you lengthen up and over that beach ball, pushing those hips a little bit further towards the left. Feeling that tremendous stretch from your fingers all the way down to your toes along the left side. Keep the weight in the heels. Engage the lower body, those thighs, those glutes are squeezed in nice and tight to help push those hips further to the left as you reach a little bit more towards the right. Palms together, biceps by the ears. Gaze towards the front, maybe up towards the ceiling, keeping the chin lifted. Breathe here. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, go a little bit deeper. Maybe find your edge. Hold it right here for 3, 2, 1, slowly rise back up, reset, re-engage. Whatever that looks like for you today, let's do the other side. Finding your breath, take a big inhale, lengthen up out of the waist. On the exhale, begin reaching over for the left. Take your time, stay with your breath. Inhale to lengthen, exhale for depth, weight in the heels. Engage the lower body, press those hips a little bit further to the right as you reach over for the left. Creating that nice deep stretch down the right side of your body, really lengthening through the left side ribcage. Palms are glued together, biceps by the ears, chin is lifted. Breathe. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, go a little bit deeper. Now try squaring your shoulders, your hips up towards the front. Pretending you're between two panes of glass here. As you reach over a little bit more towards the left, now press those hips a little bit further towards the right, keeping that core engaged. This is such a great posture to trim the waistline from the inside out. Let's reach a little bit further. Press those hips a little bit deeper. Maybe finding your edge right here. Hold it for 3, 2, 1. With control, rise back up. Good. Reset, re-engage. Going into our 10-second back bend, those arms, they can stay up in those crescent half moon grip. You can also find the lower back. Just like you're putting those hands in your back pocket. Finding guiding your breath. Take an inhale, lengthen up out of the waist. And on the exhale, begin tracing a line down that ceiling, reaching for the back wall. Hands go back. Your gaze goes back. Now press your hips forward. Really trust yourself here. Look back. Reach back for 3, 2, 1. Good. With control, rise up. And gently forward fold down to the floor. Take a moment here. Cuddle those legs up. You just built up all kinds of tension in that lower spine. Find whatever movement feels good to release it. Squats, pedals, twists. Always remembering for every deep back bend that we do in our practice, we need to do a forward fold. We need to equal out our spine. Heel toeing those feet back together if they've separated, taking a deep bend in the knees, letting the belly rest on the thighs. Now reach around and scoop up your heels. Try to get all 10 fingers underneath those heels, fingers pointed towards the front. One day your pinkies are going to touch. Those elbows are working around the calf. Finding your breath, take an inhale, now pull. Pull on your heels. Lift your hips up high in the sky, keeping the belly glued to the thighs. Bringing the forehead down to the shins as you use those muscles to pull on your heels. Lift the hips up, try to straighten those legs for 3, 2, 1. Let's release hands, find the top of the mat. Take a step or hop back, let's take it through a flow. Great job, ladies. Finding your breath here, leaning back in downward facing dog. Taking your time, making your way back up to the top of the mat. Your choice, step or hop. Just slowly round back up. Coming back to a standing position. Continuing our standing series with awkward pose. We're going to separate those feet hip width apart. Your heels are tucked right behind those toes. Arms come up parallel to the floor. Really squeezing those fingers together, engaging those triceps, rounding your shoulders down and back away from the ears. Finding your breath. Take an inhale, lengthen up. On the exhale, let's sit back deep into that chair. Keep the weight in your heels. Maybe lifting the toes to remind you here. Weight in the heels as you sit back, trying to bring those sides parallel to the floor. Lifting that upper body up. Create that C curve down that lower spine. Sit back a little bit deeper. Let's hold it here for 3, 2, 1. With control, slowly rise back up. Keep those arms nice and strong. Second part to awkward pose. Come up high on your toes. The objective for this one is heel height. I want you to focus on those heels. Your tailbone's tucked. Pretend you're flat against this back wall. Now slowly start sliding down an imaginary back wall. Keeping those heels high. Once the heels start to lower, stop there. It is more important at heel height than this one than depth. Keeping that chest lifted, keeping that tailbone tucked, finding your edge. Let's hold it right here for 3, 2, 1. Slowly rise back up. Drop the heels down, but let's keep those arms nice and strong. Third and final part to our awkward pose. Bringing those knees together to touch. Really squeezing the thighs together, coming up on those toes as much as you need to. Tailbone still tucked. Slowly start sliding down that imaginary back wall. Letting those knees press forward, maybe coming up onto your toes even more. Your hips one day, you're going to find your heels. If that's not today, that's okay. Once they do, press those knees even more towards the front. Lift that upper body up. Just pretend you're holding a box right there in the lap. Now rise up about 2 inches. Really squeeze those thighs together. Hold it right here for 3, 2, 1. All the way back up. Great job. Drop the heels down. Drop those arms down. Give that body a quick little shake. We've got one more pose. We'll take a quick little water break. Eagle is next. Heel toeing those feet back together. Arms reach up, palms touch. Find the breath. Take an inhale. Lengthen up out of the waist. On the exhale, swing the right arm underneath the left. Bringing those palms back together, thumbs towards the face. Maybe interlacing your fingers. Grabbing onto opposite shoulders is always an option. Bring those hands down below the nose. Now sit back deep into your chin. Lift the right leg up as high as you can, up over the left, pointing that toe in the direction you want it to go. One day wrapping around that standing leg calf, maybe seeing all 5 toes in that front mirror. Sit back. Really squeeze the thighs together, lifting that upper body up. Nice, strong, neutral spine here, engaging the core. Try to bring your knees and elbows back to that center line. Sit back, hold it here for 3, 2, 1. With control, rise up, unwind. Arms can swing up, maybe a little bit of a back bend, some movement, and then just a nice forward fold here. Inhale, lengthen, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. Chair pose is next. We're going to sit back deep into our chair. Bring those biceps up by the ears. Keeping the belly up off the thighs. Now swing the arms back towards the back wall, coming into a flat back. Good, right back, chair pose. Sitting back just a little bit deeper. Hands now find the heart. Take an inhale. Twist on the exhale towards the right. Left elbow on the outside of that right knee. Really pressing those palms together. Stacking those elbows. Maybe opening up the arms if you'd like. Good. Back to the center. Let's do the other side. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist for death. Twist towards the left. Right elbow on the outside of that left knee. Again, always that option. You can open up those arms. Good. Back to the center. Now sitting back a little bit deeper. Challenging right here. Arms extend straight forward. Belly up off the thighs. Let's hold it here for 3, 2, 1. Rise up. We've got one more side of eagle. Inhale, lengthen up. On the exhale, let's swing the left underneath the right. And just try to get as twisted as you can here. Bringing those shoulders down and back. Bringing those hands down below the nose. Sitting back deep into that chair. The lower you sit back, the easier it might be to wrap that leg up over the right. Pointing that toe in that direction one day. Wrapping it around that standing leg. Half of maybe seeing all 5 toes, but you've got to sit back. And you've really got to focus on squeezing those thighs together. Lift the upper body up. Core's engaged. Nice, strong, straight spine here. Sit back a little bit deeper. Bring the knees and elbows back to that center line. Hold it here for 3, 2, 1. Let's release. Hands swing up. Some movement. Release it. Let the hands find the heart. Take a nice big inhale here. Exhale. Just letting it go. We're going to take about a 10-second break. Just enough to get a small sip of water if you need one. When you're ready, meeting back in the center part of your mat. Meeting back in mountain pose, standing up nice and tall, rounding those shoulders down and back away from the ears. Taking a moment here, maybe doing a nice mini check-in with the body. We've got 4 more postures to play around with, playing around with our balance here. Always building the foundation in that standing leg, working on strengthening your standing leg. Start transitioning that weight over to the left foot, distributing that weight across all 4 corners of that foot. Engaging the left leg thigh, let's bring the right thigh up parallel to the floor. Ankle is right underneath the knee, flexing the foot's going to help level those hips out. Now this is a great place to stay. Really listen to your body here. You're ready to go forward. Inhale, lengthen up. On the exhale, let's round up over the right knee. Trying to get that 10-finger grip underneath that right foot. Once you've got the foot, kick it out towards the front. Pulling those toes back towards the face and really flexing that foot. Press that heel forward. You're trying to straighten your leg. Now 2 straight legs, 2 straight arms. You can move forward. Try gluing the belly to your thigh. Pulling that upper body down. Keeping those elbows in tight to the calf one day. Allowing the forehead to ground and touch the knee. Holding it here for 3, 2, 1. When control, let's rise up. Great job. Drop that right foot down. Maybe pedal those legs out just a little bit if you need to. Let's do the other side, forehead to knee. Transition the weight over to the right foot. Really distributing that weight across all 4 corners. Let's bring the left leg up, left thigh parallel to the floor, ankle underneath the knee. Now remember, it's such a great place to stay right here. You're always building strength, always working on balance with that standing leg. If you're ready to move forward, inhale, lengthen. On the exhale, round up over the left. Try to get that 10-finger grip. If those thumbs are on the top, try to get them underneath. Once you've got the grip, kick that foot up. Pull the toes back towards the face and really flex the foot. Press the heel forward. That's going to help straighten that leg. Feeling that nice deep stretch down the calf. 2 straight legs, 2 straight arms. Glue the belly to your thigh. Pull. Pull that upper body down. Elbows in tight to the calf. Once those elbows drop below the calf, maybe rounding the forehead to touch the knee. Let's hold it here for 3, 2, 1. With control, come out. Drop the left foot down. Maybe just pedal those legs out just a little bit. Standing big toe is next. Bring those feet back together. Shift the weight over to the left foot. Left hand finds the left hip. Taking those 2 peace fingers and thumb on your right hand. Let's pull the right toe up. Interlace it. Knees pointed up. Your tailbone touch. Your chest is lifted. Option here is to grab onto the knee. If you've got the foot, you get out towards the front here. Just until you meet resistance. When you're ready, opening up that leg towards the right side of the room. Maybe just grabbing onto the knee. Here, focusing on standing tall, left arm extends out for balance. If you want to challenge your balance here, let's take a peek at the left wall. Always an option, taking that left hand for a half rest. Good, coming back to the center. Taking that right leg up as high as you can. Hands go up, let's look up, hold it here for 3, 2, 1. Dropping it down. Coming back to the center part of your mat, shifting that weight over to the left foot, right elbow finds the right hip, palm facing up. Without twisting the wrist, drop that hand straight back. Pick up the inside of that right ankle notch. Try to get a five-finger grip around the ankle. Bringing the knees back together to touch, realigning the hips, left arm extends high, bicep by the ear, palm facing forward. Now really listen to your body here. This is a great place to stay when you're ready. Staying with your breath. Inhale, lengthen up. On the exhale, let's start to kick. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, kick for depth. Kicking into that right hand. Letting that kick just drive your upper body down. One day, maybe parallel to the floor, but no lower than that. Reaching that left arm forward. Is it the arrow to this posture? Engaging that left arm. Try to touch that front mirror in front of you. Kicking into the right hand. Create the bow. Kicking into that right hand, maybe as hard as you can. That foot wants to fling out, but your grip is nice and tight. Just imagine being pulled in opposite directions. That's what's going to help you balance. Kicking and reaching with that same intensity. Staying focused on one point, maybe in the front mirror, maybe down on your mat somewhere. Try not to look around. Stay focused here. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, kick a little bit deeper. Holding it here. Finding your edge. Maybe going a little bit deeper. Maybe challenging this pose. Getting right back into it. Finding your edge. Let's hold it here for 3, 2, 1. Rise back up. Good. Drop it down. Let's shake it up. Do the other side. Shift that weight over. Left elbow, left hip, palm facing up. Without twisting the wrist, we drop it straight back, picking up the inside of the left ankle notch. Bringing the knees back together to touch. Realigning the hips. Let's bring that right arm up. Bicep by here. Again, take as much time as you need to right here. Maybe the entire 60 seconds. When you're ready, find that point wherever it's at. Inhale, lengthen up. And on the exhale, let's begin to kick. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, kick for depth. Stay with your breath. So important here to keep breathing. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, kick. Kick into that left hand. Work on creating the bow with that left leg. Those toes, they're driving up towards that ceiling. One day, letting that left hand slide down that shin, maybe working into a standing split. Now your right arm, it reaches forward. Try to touch that front mirror in front of you. Kicking and reaching with that same intensity. Again, that's what's going to help you balance here. Checking back in with that right leg. Is it nice and strong? You're almost there. Hold on to it. Keep kicking. Keep reaching. Finding your edge. Now go a little bit deeper. Challenge. Right here. Hold it for 3, 2, 1. Good job right now. Dropping that left leg down, shaking those legs out a little bit. And take a nice big step back towards the back of the mat. We've got one set of balancing stick today. Working on our airplane pose. Arms reach up, palms touch, cross the thumbs. Finding that breath, take an inhale, lengthen up out of the waist. On the exhale, let's step forward on the right foot. As you come down, arms swoop back towards the back wall. Left leg reaches back, flexing that left foot. Putting that footprint on that back wall. Now point the toes down. Realigning those hips. Hands find the heart. Warrior three. You can stay right here if you want to advance this a little bit. Arms extend forward. Biceps by the ears. Let's hold it for 3, 2, 1. Great job. Rise up. Let's do the other side. Arms reach back up. Maybe swapping out the crossing of your thumbs. Take a big inhale. Lengthen up. And on the exhale, let's step forward on the left. As you come down, arms swoop back. Right leg reaches back, flexing that right foot, pointing those toes down, squaring those hips up, finding your balance, airplane pose. Hands now find the heart, warrior three. Maybe staying here, maybe advancing this just a little bit. Reach those arms forward, biceps by the ears. Let's hold it here for 3, 2, 1. Rise up, great job. Hands find the heart. Let's take a nice big inhale and exhale, turning over onto our backs, getting into our first little mini Shavasana. We'll take about a 60-second break. Taking those small sips of water, but just dropping down as quick as you can. Trying to find stillness for 60 seconds here. Arms can rest down by your sides, palms facing up, kind of finding that Shavasana, that corpse pose. Closing the eyes if that feels good for you. Maybe a soft gaze up towards the ceiling. Letting the body rest here, letting the mind rest. Maybe finding your breath, taking a nice deep inhale through the nose. Just exhale that air out. Back around, reverse it, falling triangle. hand. Left hand to the mat, right arm reaches forward, extend at side angle stretch. Good, bring the right hand down to the mat, pivot up on that back foot. Left hand's gonna reach up, gaze goes up. Take this side for a half wrap. Release that half wrap, let's tumble our warrior. Left hand drops down, circles along the inside of that left ankle. Dropping down to that right elbow. Just letting the head hang heavy here. Let the body rest. Let that heart rate come down. Always that option, you can drop that right knee down to the mat. Good, press the left hand into the floor. Back foot pivots down, right hand extends high. Taking this side for a half wrap, maybe a full wrap, making that full bind. If you've got that full bind in Birds of Paradise in your practice, slowly make your way into that. Finding your balance. Good, when you're ready to release, let's meet back, prayer lunge. Finding that breath here, take a nice big inhale. On the exhale, twist towards the left side of the room. Right up on the outside of that left knee, maybe opening up the arm. Good, coming back, holding it here. Dropping the hands down to the mat, stepping that left foot back, taking it through a flow. Moving back, downward facing dog. Take a couple breaths here. Moving on to flow two. Right leg extends high. Come all the way into warrior two. Take a moment here, take a breath, sink a little bit deeper. Good, straightening that front leg. Let's pivot towards the left side of the room. Toes can be slightly pigeon-toed here. Taking a big inhale, lengthen up on the exhale, swan dive down. Reaching for the outside of those ankles, your feet. Maybe interlacing the peace fingers around your big toes. Now pull. Use those muscles here. Try to straighten those legs. Bringing that forehead down to the mat. Keeping that back nice and strong, nice straight spine here. Option, you can always play around with that head to dance. Taking a few breaths, feeling that nice stretch down the back of your legs. Taking one more breath wherever you're at, working your way back down, coming to that flat back. Take your time. Arms extend out into airplane wings, really engage the core. Let's rise back up, come back into warrior two. Good, circle your arms around, step the right leg back. Open up to the left side of the room for a side plank. Two arms in one line, press those hips high. Option here is to drop that right knee down to the floor. If you want a challenge, left arm's gonna reach forward, bicep by the ear, try lifting that left leg high. Good, come around, high plank. Hold it here for five breaths. Option, do some push-ups. Maybe dropping the knees down to the mat. Five push-ups, maybe your goal is just one. You don't have to do five when you're ready. Drop it down, take it through that flow. Meeting back, downward facing dog. Good, let's do the other side. Left leg extends high. Step it all the way in, warrior two. Take a breath here. Take a moment, maybe sink a little bit deeper. Good, straighten the front leg. Let's pivot towards the right side. This side's gonna be a little bit different. Interlace those fingers behind you. Gluing those palms together, take a little bit of a back bend here. And when you're ready, forward fold down to the floor. Allowing the hands to come up off the lower back, reaching for that floor. Nice deep shoulder stretch here. You want to find some movement that might feel good to help release the shoulders just a little bit more. Good, come to that flat back, airplane arms. Drop the right hand down in front of you, left hand extends high, gaze goes up. Taking this side for that half wrap, maybe rolling that left shoulder open just a little bit more. Come back to the center. Drop the left hand down in front of you, right hand reaches high. Taking this side for that half wrap. Releasing that back to the center, airplane wings, engage the core, let's rise all the way back up. Back into warrior two. Circle those arms around, step the left foot back, let's open up to the right side. Side plank, option, drop that knee down to the mat if you need to. If you want a challenge, right arm reaches forward, bicep by the ear, maybe lifting the right leg high. Good, come back around, high plank. Hold it here for five breaths, maybe some push-ups, it's up to you. Whenever dropping it down, taking it through that flow, meeting back downward facing dog. Maybe taking a breath in child's pose. We'll take just a quick moment if you need a small sip of water. Just about 10 seconds or so. Flow three, last push of our practice right here. Everything after this flow, we're gonna slow it all the way down. Taking flow four right on into pigeon to let the body rest. If you're ready, making your way back, downward facing dog. Take a nice big inhale, right leg extends high. Step it all the way in. This is your last warrior one on this side. Making it as good as that first one you started out with. Open up warrior two. Straightening the front leg, adjusting the distance between your feet as much as you need to. Reach past those toes, dropping down triangle pose. Right hand can find the shin, the top of the foot, maybe the mat. If you have a block, use that block. Left arm extends forward, bicep by the ear. If you want a little bit more core work, put that right arm up parallel to the left. Good, both hands come down to the mat. Step that back foot up about halfway. Left hand stays down, right hand reaches high, gaze goes up. Taking this side for a half wrap. Releasing that, right hand drops down. Now shifting the weight into that right leg. Left leg comes up, arms reach back, airplane pose. Squeeze that shoulder blade together. Find your balance right here. Hands to the heart. Good, drop them down to the mat, standing split. Those hands can rest out to the sides of your foot for balance. If you want a little bit more, take that right hand, wrap it around the right foot, pull the forehead to the shin, lifting the left leg up a little higher. Good, bring that left leg down parallel to the floor. Right hand out in front of the right foot, left hand extends high, stacking the shoulders, two arms, one line, stack those hips, find your balance in half moon. Hands down to the heart, let's reverse, then you're done. Left hand to the floor, right hand reaches high. Holding it here, lifting that left leg up a little higher. Good, drop it all down. Stepping it back, take it through a flow. Great job, everybody. We've got one more side, and then slowing it all the way down. Reach the left leg high, point the toe. Step it all the way in. Last warrior one on this side, strong warrior one. Open up warrior two. Straightening that front leg, dropping down into triangle pose. Reach forward, left hand to the shin, to the foot, to the mat, maybe a block. Keeping that upper body engaged, try not to dump into this left side. Right arm reaches forward, bicep by the ear. If you want a challenge, bring that left arm up parallel to the right. Good, both hands down to the mat. Step that back foot up about halfway. Reversing that triangle. Right hand stays down, left hand extends. Taking this side for a half wrap. Releasing that, here we go. Let's fly, shift the weight into that left foot. Right leg reaches back, arms reach back. Find your balance, airplane pose. Good, hands to the heart. Dropping down, standing split. Taking the left hand, wrapping it around that left calf, pull that forehead to the shin. Try lifting the right leg up a little higher. Dropping that right leg down, parallel to the floor. Left hand out in front of the left foot, right hand reaches high. Find your balance, half moon, stack those hips, stack the shoulders. Good, hands find the heart, let's reverse, then you're done. Right hand down, left hand reaches high. Lifting that right leg up a little higher. Great job, guys. Drop it down. Let's step it back. Let's take it through a flow. Shaking out those legs. Shake out the body. Skip your flow. That's okay. Knee back and down dog. We've made it. We're going to rest right here in pigeon. Right leg reaches high. Maybe a little higher. Just really stretching it out. Step it all the way into your pigeon pose. Coming down onto the mat. Letting that right knee find the edge of your mat, bringing your right foot back by your left hip, lengthening that left leg back. Maybe taking a nice big inhale to lengthen up. And on your exhale, forward fold down to the floor. We'll take a few moments here in pigeon, just feeling that nice compression in the right hip. Trying to keep those hips square to the floor. Always that option if you want to slide that block underneath that right hip to help support just a little bit more. Let that head hang heavy. Catch your breath here. Let the body rest. that like to play around with mermaid or maybe the splits, now's the time to do so. Maybe today you just want to hang out here and pigeon a little bit longer. That's okay too. If you've never done mermaid before, I want you to start bending that back knee, reaching for that foot. Just maybe playing around with this quad stretch. One day that foot's going to find that elbow crease and you can reach for that full bind. Good. When you're ready to release, stepping the right leg back, let's take it through our last flow on this side. Taking your time through this flow. Bring that breath back to the body, meeting back downward facing dog. Let's do the other side. Left leg extends high, maybe reaching it up just a little bit more here. When you're ready, stepping it all the way into pigeon on your left side. Bring that knee out to the edge of that mat. This is a hip opener. Left foot finds the right hip, maybe flexing that left foot a little bit more. Lengthen that right leg back. When you're ready, big inhale. Exhale, forward fold, dropping down. Maybe to the elbows. Maybe letting the belly rest on that leg, stretching those arms out. Forehead can find the mat. Forehead can find blocks. Maybe stacking those fists, using them as a pillow. Just letting that body rest here. Taking as much time as you'd like to in this resting position, really listening to your body. If you want to play around with mermaid, maybe the splits on this side. Taking your time to do so here. Bending that back knee, reaching for that foot. Just trying to keep your hips square, whether you're in pigeon, mermaid, or the split. Finding one more breath, letting that body just settle a little bit more into whatever has the most tension. And when you're ready to release, taking your time here, step the left leg back. Let's take it through our last flow of class. Bringing that breath back to the body here, meeting back in downward facing dog, taking a couple petals here, shifting that weight around. When you're ready, coming into a high plank for the count of five. Nice, strong plank. Slowly lower the body all the way down to the floor. Letting that belly just find the mat. Moving right up into cobra pose. Taking it into our spine series. Palms underneath the shoulders, elbows pointed up. Zipping those legs up nice and tight all the way down to the toes. And pressing the tops of the feet into the mat. Lifting the knees, the thighs up off the floor. Now find your breath. Take an inhale and lift your upper body up on that exhale. Little to no pressure in the hands. Lifting that upper body up just a little bit higher. Good. Dropping it down right here to the floor. Arms are going to rest down by your sides. Just finding a breath here. Take a moment. Letting that spine come back down to a neutral position. Receiving all of the benefits here. Airplane is next. We're going to combine the airplane and locust pose today. Bringing the chin back to the center part of the mat. Extending those arms out into your airplane wings. Zipping those legs up nice and tight here. Find that breath. Take a big inhale. On the exhale, lift that upper body up. Toes come up. Fly. Maybe flying a little bit higher. When you're ready, reaching those hands back towards the back. Interlace those fingers. Reaching back. Lifting those toes up for 3, 2, 1. Dropping it down. Left ear to the floor. Arms can rest. Let the body rest here. We've got one more right here on our belly. Bringing that chin back to the center. Floor bow is next. Bending the knees, reaching back, driving just below those toes. And if you've got them, try to bring those knees back together. Really finding that breath. Take an inhale. On the exhale, kick into those hands, lifting that upper body up, creating that bow, creating that teardrop from the side. As you kick a little bit higher, hold it here for 3, 2, 1. Let's release. Great job. belly. Knees come into the chest. Give them a big squeeze here. Maybe shifting from side to side, massaging your lower spine. Now reach the feet up high to your sky. Arms rest down by your sides, lengthening the legs nice and long, and keeping the feet flat. I want you to slowly lower those legs all the way down to the mat for your count of 10. Going as fast or as slow as you want to go, just really keeping that core in nice and tight. Our yogi sit-up is next. Arms extend up above the head, palms facing up, cross the thumbs. Zip those legs up, keep those feet flexed. Taking a big inhale, big full body stretch. On that exhale, reach up for the ceiling and then roll over for the toes, stretching it up. And making your way to the top of the mat. Fix firm is next. Starting on our knees in hero's pose. Knees together, hips find the heels, shoulders above the hips. Hero's pose is such a great place to stay. Be very mindful of your knees in this pose. If you want to go a little bit further, keep the knees together. Try separating the feet. Separating those feet enough to allow your hips to find the floor. If you want to slide a block underneath those hips, that might help support. This is still too much. I want you to come back up on your heels and just stay there for today. Once your hips find the floor, hands find the feet, let's drop down one elbow at a time. Also a great place to stay, right here. Really listen to your body. If you can go even further and your shoulders meet the mat, reach up, grab opposite elbow. Maybe slight tuck, chin to chest, creating that nice C curve down that lower spine. Kind of a mini back bend here. Wherever you're at, just really encourage those knees to come back together a little bit. Just find your breath. Kind of settle into this pose. Kind of an awkward one, but you're receiving so many benefits at any stage of this posture. When you're ready to release, coming out as slowly as you went in, hands find the feet, one elbow at a time, gently lifting back up. Turning towards the left side of the room, we're going to do frog pose. I'll instruct for frog. I know a lot of you really like yogi squats, so it's up to you. Frog pose, separating those knees as wide as you can on the mat. Keep going even further than the knees. Maybe just right behind the knees, dropping down to those elbows. Keeping that core in tight. Try not to dip into that lower spine. Take an inhale. Exhale, press back. Press back into those hips. One of our deepest hip openers, frog pose. If you like to find movement, maybe inhale again, press forward, and on the exhale, come back a little bit deeper.
Forward fold. So reach your hands around, grab onto those heels. You might not be able to
pull. Pull on those heels, lift the hips high, maintaining the forehead to knee connection. We're rounding the spine, lengthening the spine here. If you've lost that connection, walk those knees up. Pull on the heels, lift the hips high. One day stacking right above the knees. And just remember, keep the weight out of your neck. Hold it here. And when you're ready, really slowly unwind. Let those hips just find the floor. Moving on to separate leg stretch. We're almost there, guys. Right leg kicks out towards the right corner of the mat. Bring that left foot into the inner right thigh. Arms are going to reach up overhead. Take an inhale to lengthen up. On the exhale, let's forward fold. Hinging at the hips. Reaching for that right foot. Pulling that forehead down. Maybe one day touching that right knee. Keeping those elbows in tight. We're kind of mirroring that forehead to knee in our balancing series. When you're ready to release, letting go, rising back up, swapping out those legs, left leg kicks out, right foot comes in, arms reach up, big inhale, lengthen up on the exhale, glue the belly to your thigh, reach for that left foot, pulling that upper body down. If you can't quite grab the foot, that's okay, use a towel, use a strap, you can grab onto the ankle or the calf. Just try to keep this posture active. Rounding the forehead, one day touching the knee. And we're release. Butterfly is next, bringing the soles of your feet together to touch. Bringing those feet in as close to the body as you'd like to today. Interlacing the fingers, wrapping them around the toes. Keeping your back nice and strong here. Take an inhale. On the exhale, guide with your chest. Pull that upper body down. You want to press those elbows into the legs, maybe opening up those hips just a little bit more, you can. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, go a little bit deeper, right at the very end. When you can't go any further at that point, maybe round the forehead to touch the toes. And when you're ready to really slowly unwind, let's turn around towards the back wall. Let's take it into our shoulder stand and our plow combo. Maybe taking this kind of at your own pace here, bringing your back down to the mat, knees come into the chest. You don't want to roll up onto those shoulders today. You don't have to. Keep the hips on the floor. Just elevate the legs up nice and high. Whenever you're ready, using some momentum, rolling up onto the shoulders. Hands can find the lower back. Pressing those hips up one day, getting them above the shoulders, toes pointed up towards the ceiling. Maybe walking those hands down the back just a little bit more to lift those hips up a little bit higher. But keeping the weight out of the neck. Really distribute that weight across the entire shoulder blade. And when you're ready for plow, you can start lowering those toes down. You have a couple options here for plow. You can keep those legs straight all the way down, letting the toes find the floor, really pressing those heels forward. You can bend the knees, massage those temples, maybe work the hands around the back, make a bind. Just take a moment here, plow. When you're ready to release, with control, slowly lowering one vertebrae down at a time. Grabbing onto that right knee as it passes, lengthening that left leg all the way down to the mat. Taking it into our wind relieving pose, flexing that left foot, keeping that leg active. Take that right knee, avoid the rib cage, and pull that knee deep into that right shoulder. Having a white knuckle grip here, really using your muscles. When you're ready for your spine twist, taking that knee across the upper body, extending that right arm out, trying to keep both shoulder blades square to the mat, really staying with your breath here. Inhale to lengthen, exhale for depth. Allow that knee to sink a little bit deeper. Coming back to the center, bringing both knees in for a big squeeze. Let's do the other side. Grabbing onto that left knee, lengthening the right. Lengthening that right leg all the way down to the floor. Flexing that right foot, keeping that leg active. Take the left knee. Get the ribcage out of the way. Pull that left knee deep into the left shoulder. Taking your time here. Whenever you're ready for that spine twist, across the upper body. Lengthening the left arm out. Again, keeping both shoulder blades square to the mat here. Letting that left knee just sink towards the floor on the exhale. When you're ready to release, bringing those knees back together, giving them one final squeeze here. If you want to find some movement, maybe shifting that weight around, Happy Baby is a great option. And if there's any other pose that your body's still kind of craving, feel free to play around with that. You're ready for that final Shavasana. Our feet reach up nice and high here. Slowly lowering them all the way down towards the mat. With control, use the core. Letting those toes flop open. Letting the arms rest down by your side. Palms facing up. Just trying to get nice and comfortable on the mat. We'll take a few moments here in our Shavasana. Finding our breath. Taking some nice deep inhales through the nose. Really feeling that belly rise. And on the exhale, let the belly fall. Let that body melt a little bit deeper into the mat. Stay with your breath. Let the body, let the mind find some stillness. Really taking this time to acknowledge your practice today. Enjoying this moment, this present moment on your mat, in the space that you've created for it. Just letting everything rest. Such an important part of our practice, finding a few moments in your Shavasana. Taking as much time as you need here today. Thank you so much for joining us. Have such a wonderful rest of your day. Stay healthy. Namaste.